situation in hour 10.
Oh, man. This guy's the man, bro. Fuck! This guy's so good, man.
When you look in the dugout right now,
how is DJ?
This is way right now.
Bro, this DJ guy is a cheat code. How was Brian Cashman allowed to have this man in pinstripes? Is beyond me. How? Just how? Oh my God.
Breaking news. Woo! DJ LeMahieu is back with the New York Yankees.
Ladies and gentlemen,
love so hard to find.
We got him.
If this is your first time on the channel, make sure you hit a like and subscribe to the page and let us know exactly how you feel about this deal. 6 years, $90 million reported by Jeff Passan. We don't know all of the things, you know, within the deal and the inner workings or whatever, but that seems to be what the deal is going to be. I think this is a great deal for the Yankees. I think it gives DJ LeMahieu kind of like what he wants. It gives the Yankees what they want, which is flexibility. Now he's at $15 million per year. Some people say, oh man, what do you mean? Like, this is a long deal for a guy that's going to be turning 33. I get it. I understand the sentiment, but $15 million is not money that you feel that you cannot maneuver around, even at that age where, you know, his final year of his contract. That's like easily tradable. You can offset it with other things if you want to trade him out, if it doesn't happen, or he might be producing and still be producing over his contract value. This is a win for the freaking Yankees. Also, it looks like the Jays were in on him and they offered him 4 years, $78 million. Maybe you might want to get a place to actually play. I know you got Buffalo and all that stuff, but the place is not well lit. Nobody really knows where the hell they're going to be playing. It's going to be really tough for them to sign for some free agents. Nice to see DJ LeMahieu back in pinstripes. Obviously, he didn't want to deal with this free agency stuff any longer. It gives the Yankees some great stuff going forward. Now they can be able to add more things. And now a flurry of rumors, and you're starting to see the cold stove starts to thaw out. As we said yesterday in the podcast, we got to record a new podcast now talking about this new stuff, because all that other news from before is old news. It's all about the new news right now. This is an exciting day. Glad to have DJ back, our freaking gold glove batting champ, back at second base. We actually need a starting pitcher, and it looks like the Yankees are in on Kluber, and they might be in on something else as well, according to MLB Network Radio.
I'm also told they may also get a starting pitcher here in the next 24-48 hours. I know they had a scout in here seeing Corey Kluber. They like what they saw there. It could be him. I know they've been in trade talks with the Reds regarding Luis Castillo, although I understand there hasn't been recent talks, but they've been involved in talks with the Reds regarding him. So, you know, the Yankees, once you have the announcement for LeMahieu, the next thing you're going to see is them get a starting pitcher. And so they've been working like both sides. That's kind of their offseason goal. But they made it clear to all of us, publicly, privately, every way, that the number one priority was DJ, period. Like, they didn't waver off of that. That was what they wanted to do. And obviously it's getting done today. So a good job by John Morosi of MLB Network Radio and other entities for breaking the news early in the morning. Great job for him, and good for Yankee fans. They got to be a little relieved this morning.
You know, if they are moving quickly, Duke, as JB suggests on the starter, Kluber certainly makes the most sense.
Yeah, so as you said right there, it looks like, I mean, Luis Castillo, I don't know, the Yankees called in about that. That's interesting. I would love Luis Castillo. Get me both of them. Give me both of them. This deal gives the Yankees flexibility to be able to do things. They have about like $20 million more to be able to spend or so, because DJ's deal that they have here. So let's see what they can be able to do before they reach that payroll mark at the top. Looks like Kluber might be with the Yankees. I know the Yankees are in on him, so they like what they saw. They were impressed with it, would like it. And then Kluber says he would like to have a one-year deal to prove it. I love the prove it deals. Love them, because it shows that you're going to get the best out of the player. Not that I was doubting a guy like Kluber or whatever. He's not the guy from 2016, but if a guy that wants to prove himself, that feels like he can be back up there the very next year, I want to see that out of them. And give me some more. But let me know in the comments what you guys think about this deal, number one. Number two, also let me know who you guys want, if you guys do want somebody, or what you want, who you want your team to get, and follow Pinstripe Strong on Twitter and Instagram. The Instagram post, like and tag two of your friends, and I'm going to be giving away a jersey, guys, a New York Yankees jersey to celebrate DJ LeMahieu coming back. So make sure you guys do that. Follow Pinstripe Strong on Instagram and go ahead and do that, all right? But like I always say, make sure you guys keep your pinstripes on. Stay pinstripe strong. Let's go, Yankees!
Peace. You guys are going hard.
Yeah.
Who pushes you the most?
No one in practice could guard me, so it's really nothing. We can put the camera on him, too. Just put the camera on him. That man right there, that's the man who can't guard me. Turn it left. I'll take his ankles every day. Go one more. See the boy in the hoodie. He hiding for a reason. They all know the deal. Yes, I took old soul. I did.